How can you find the LU factorization of a matrix A? You'll see how to do this in the example in this video. So we start with a big matrix A over here. I want to find L and U such that A equals L times U. So what are we going to do? First we'll have to reduce A to its echelon form. So we want to have zeros here. We can only use row additions. We don't want to use swaps or multiplication or whatever. So we add the first row twice to the second row. We subtract the first row once from the third row. And we add the first row three times to the last row. So what do we get? The first row remains the same over here. And then adding the first row twice to the second row, you get 4 minus 4 equals 0. 2 times 4 equals 8 minus 5 equals 3. 2 times minus 1 equals minus 2 plus 3 equals 1. 2 times 5 equals 10 minus 8 equals 2. 2 times minus 2 equals minus 4 plus 1 equals 1. And that's how you find the new second row. Ah, okay, you can do the third and fourth row yourself. Then we continue. We want to make zeros over here. So that means that we have to add the second row twice to the third row. And we have to add the second row minus 4 times to the last row. So let me copy that. Plus 3. Minus 4. So what do we get? First row doesn't change. Second row doesn't change, of course. What happens to the second row? We add 3 times 3 to minus 9, which gives us a 0. We add 3 times 1 to minus 3, which gives us another 0. We add 3 times 2 to equals 6 to minus 4, which gives us a 2. So this becomes a 2, as you see. And we add 3 times minus 3 to 10, which gives 10 minus 9 equals a 1 over here. And fourth row goes similarly. You can do that one yourself. Then in the last step, want to make a 0 here. So add minus 2 times the third row to the fourth one. So you get the zeros remain the same. And you get minus 4 plus 4 equals a 0 over here. And minus 2 plus 7 equals 5 over here. And there you have your U for your LU decomposition. So now how do you find the L matrix? Now then we start with the last operation, which was add a minus 2 times the third row to the fourth row. We start with that one and we do its inverse. So instead of adding a minus 2 times the third row to the fourth row, we add now the third row 2 times to the fourth row. We do plus 2 over here, and that's our first step. Now what's the next step? What did we do in the second step? Well, we added the second row 3 times to the third row, and we subtracted the second row 4 times from the fourth row. So what do? Now we subtract the second row 3 times from the third row, and we add the second row minus plus 4 times to the third row. So then we get from this, we get the minus 3 and plus 4. So that yields the minus 3 and the plus 4 over here. And notice that this addition doesn't do anything with this part of the matrix, because you are adding something which only has 1 over here. And then in the last step, what did we do in our first step? We did a plus 2 minus 1 and a plus 3 over here. So we do the inverse operations now. So that means a minus 2, a plus 1 and a minus 3. And that yields some numbers in the first column. So the numbers over here. And there you have your L. So how do you find your L and your U? You use this standard. You do the row reduction of your matrix A. Then how to find your L? You start with the appropriate identity matrix and look at those operations. First the last step, this one, and then the step before that, and then the first step. You do the same operations inverse order. Well, you do the inverse operations in the inverse order, and there you have your L as well.